Ach so, how you do you? Jack Yak. My name Jack Yak, but my friends all call me Jack. Jack can't understand why you yak, yak, yak when Jack tell you his name's Jack Yak. A yak is animal with long curly hair. I look a lot like an ox. I roam the plains of Tibet, oh yeah, just like deer and fox. Jack Yak, my name Jack Yak, but my friends all call me Jack. You fellow Jack, I'll make you a snack. You want to lie down Jack's back?
Say, you're all right, Yak. Jack. We'd like to take you up on your kind offer, but we're looking for that treacherous villain, Haley Comet, who stole the rocket ship from the... Who's that?
Run for your lives! Here comes the abominable snowman!
Hey, you come back. Don't be afraid of Ab. He no hurt you. He nice guy. Come, I introduce you. Ab, here are my new friends, Wynken, Blynken, and Nod. Honorable new friends, meet Ab, abominable snowman.
Hi, fellas. Glad to meet you.
Hi.
Gee, you sure are a giant.
You sure are. We just stopped off to see if we could find a real nasty guy called Haley Comet who stole a rocket ship from the man on the moon. You haven't seen him around, have you?
Oh, you must be talking about that fellow we just caught, who was flying around without a pilot's license. Oh, he's in a lot of trouble. Oh, he ran out of fuel and landed on our mountaintop. He was so nasty, when we went to help him, we just froze him in a block of ice.
They froze him in a block of ice, all right. Brr, I'm cold just thinking about it. The abominable snowman took them to Haley, where they found him yelling and screaming.
Help! Oh, get me out of here, please! Don't leave me here to die in this desolate spot with all those abominable monsters!
You really don't deserve any pity after all the terrible things you've done.
Oh, please, please, I'm filled with remorse. I'll do anything you say.
Will you promise to give the rocket ship back to the man on the moon?
Take it! Take it! It's yours! I mean his!
And do you promise to give the walrus tooth back to Wally?
Oh, with great haste! Yes, sir! With great haste!
And will you promise not to return until you're supposed to, in 75 years, that is?
Yes, I promise. My conduct will be above reproach from now on.
Huh. How do we know you'll keep your promise? You've tricked us before.
I'll tell you what I'll do. Oh, no, I just can't do it.
Oh, yes, you can. What?
Oh, I'll be completely humiliated. The laughingstock of all the other comets. But if you promise to deliver me from this icy cubicle, I'll let you cut off my beautiful long tail and keep it for as long as you like. Without it, I can travel nowhere.
Okay, I guess that'll be punishment enough for you. It's a deal. Come on, fellas, let's get a blowtorch and melt him out of that block of ice.
Blowtorch? Oh, Gadzooks, what are you going to do, burn me alive? I promise to be good. Oh.
No, we're just going to melt the ice around you. We'll be careful. Now just calm down and hold still. We'll have you free in a minute.
In a short while, Haley Comet was free. He thanked our little friends over and over again and very meekly climbed into the little wooden shoe for his journey back to the planet Neptune. Nod took the rocket ship back to the man in the moon, who was so happy to see it again. And last but not least, they thanked their guardian angel, Miss Guiding Star, for all her help.